morning, everyone. How are you today? A lot of people. Good. Thank you for coming. I am Robert Prochowicz. I am a sales engineer at MicroStrategy. MicroStrategy is analytics and mobility platform. I am 10 years with the company, serving customers in Nordics countries and the Netherlands. And I will have a pleasure to show you this presentation today to you. The topic is modern data management and data science. This is from the point of view of us. We are analytics platform, so we provide reporting, dashboards, alerts to big organizations. So how we see this layer of data, data science, that we not necessarily do, but we. So this is our view on this part of the market. This is a map. MicroStrategy is 30 years on the market already. There are some key milestones. A big milestone we did in 2017 when we have introduced APIs. So we have opened our platform, and this opened completely new world of opportunities. So last year, 2018, it was possible to integrate MicroStrategy with Alexa, for example. So now you can ask your questions with your voice. Natural language processing is possible right now. Augmented reality, so you can scan or you can take a picture of whatever, of a product on a shelf, and you can get a report directly on the same screen, maybe on your tablet. All thanks to those APIs that we provide. But 2018 is over, now we have 2019. And when you look at 2019, many of you are probably looking at Gartner reports. So there are many of them, but if you look at data management and solutions for analytics, so you see big players in the leaders quadrant, Oracle, Microsoft, Teradata, they are here based mostly because of huge user base, huge customer base. So they are still here, but they are. I would like to highlight those two, Snowflake and Google. We see them growing. We see them emerging at our customers. So they are very aggressive, very dynamic, and we see them more and more. It's interesting that Gartner didn't put Hadoop much higher or much to the right. The Hadoop is still in this niche players quadrant. So even Gartner doesn't really see much progress with those technologies. In the data science and machine learning quadrant, you have those old players like SAS or TIBCO in this leaders quadrant. But you have those challengers like Alteryx and Dataiku. They have their booths here. So you see they are also growing. They are also getting more and more popularity, more and more customers. Now, again, from MicroStrategy point of view, it's of course it's just a selection, it's a fraction of the market. So the main points we would like to highlight. So again, Google and Snowflake, cloud data warehouses, growing. Also in the Nordics countries, we see them showing up at our traditional customers, and our customers are mostly big organizations in retail, in finance. Is there anyone from Teradata here? No? I talked to Teradata people yesterday. I asked them about Snowflake. Is it a threat to them? And they said, no. So I think they might be surprised pretty soon. if they still think companies like Snowflake is not a threat to them, because it's good technology. But if we have a Google Cloud on this chart, providing data storage features in different forms, of course we must mention AWS and Microsoft, which provide, of course, Redshift or SQL Server or whatever, or Hadoop. They have a lot of options to store data on the cloud platforms. So those are like SQL data sources, let's say, on this part of the chart. If you are talking about NoSQL products, I would mention products like MongoDB or Elastic. So they are meant to store non-structured data. I mean, developers nowadays got a bit lazy. A few years ago, it was a standard. If you build an application, if you build software, you would use MySQL. You would build tables. You would have schema. It's strict. You need to stick to some rules. So people got lazy. Now you see more and more people building applications on MongoDB or Elastic. So there's no structure. You just drop everything there, and then you will think later what to do with this. But apparently it works. So it's getting more and more popular. Regarding streaming, Kafka, open source, and Confluent, they also hear that productionalized Kafka, make it more enterprise. So the data, coming from different sources can be streamed, directed to somewhere, wherever you like. So with those technologies and many more, there's a new problem, and there are companies that help to solve this problem, which is performance. Companies like Indexima or Dreamio, they can connect to SQL or non-SQL data and make it faster. So they create virtual in-memory layer where you can put all of this data, gigabytes, billions of rows, and make it extremely fast for us, for analytics companies like MicroStrategy, Qlik, Tableau, Power BI. They make it really fast. Other vendors like Kivos or AdScale, they can also connect to MDX sources like SAP Business Warehouse or Microsoft Cubes. So we see those companies coming. They help solve these performance issues. And we were doing tests, and their results are really, really amazing. Now, data science and machine learning. A lot of options, and you have a lot of vendors just behind these doors. I will not mention all of them. I can only mention what we have as MicroStrategy. We have connectors, we have libraries for Python and R that make it extremely easy to your data scientists to connect to MicroStrategy and move data both ways with those libraries. And they also help to connect to tools like Kaggle or Dataiku with Python, and those connectors, you can push data to MicroStrategy or from MicroStrategy to those tools, do machine learning, processing, and push it back to MicroStrategy for reporting. So that's a general overview of this market. I would like to show you an example, a video that we made with Snowflake that will show you how this modern cloud data warehouse can operate with analytics platform. So this is MicroStrategy. I thought I know the shortcut to pause this, but it doesn't work here. Is it paused now? Okay. How did I do it? Okay, just tapping. Okay. This is MicroStrategy dossier, sales data, and now the customer wants to incorporate weather data to put it as additional layer and see if weather influences sales. So this customer is using Snowflake. Snowflake allows companies to share data sets. So you can buy weather data and get access on the cloud to this weather data so you can add it to your dashboards. Pretty nice feature. So how you do it? You just add new data. You choose Snowflake as a connector. You select tables. So you see all of those tables available to you through your account. Add it. But there is a problem. The data is in JSON format. It's not structured. So it's a bit difficult to report this. On this, in Snowflake, you fix it by building a view, relational view. So then when you import this, it's much easier for ad hoc queries. There was an interface that allowed you either to connect live to Snowflake, so each query will go to Snowflake and execute, and will go, the results will get back. Or you could take this data and put in memory of MicroStrategy for fast performance. But with Snowflake, it's fast anyhow. Now you add additional layer to the map called weather, and you add some other KPIs, and voila. Now you will see two layers on the map. One is sales as a polygons, and weather are those little blue dots, so you can compare compare those two factors if there's any interference with sales. With MicroStrategy, we incorporated natural language processing, so you can type your questions like what's the average sales, and MicroStrategy just immediately creates a visualization for you. That's a cool feature. We introduced this a month ago. We call it HyperCards or HyperIntelligence. You don't need to go to BI tool to run a report. Wherever you are, if you are Googling for something, you see this is underlined, so you put your mouse over it and you have a report right in front of you. So it pops up. It can be about your customers, about your products, about your employees, about whatever you like. So it delivers analytics to your users immediately. It increases the adoption of analytics. And this one is based on Snowflake again, so you see how fast it is. You just move your mouse, you get the report. And right where you need it. And then there's a link back to MicroStrategy dashboard if you need more details. So you can pass the parameters, pass the filter value. Okay, so I want to show you a little bit more information about Google again. Again, it's just a selection of tools. There are so many, we have only 20 minutes, I cannot talk about all of them. If you are a MicroStrategy user, what options do you have if you are thinking about Google Cloud? So, first of all, we have connectors to BigQuery. We have connectors to Cloud SQL. It's very well tested, very well documented, best practices, runs fast, and good technology. Then, for hosting, you can install MicroStrategy on Compute Engine. For machine learning, whether it's TensorFlow or other tools Google offers, you can use those libraries I've mentioned that we have for Python or for R to integrate those models with MicroStrategy platform and move data between them. From consumer Google Cloud, we have integration with Google Clouds, Google Drive, Sheets, and Docs. So you can import or export both ways. In Gmail, you have those hypercards, for example, so you can get reports from Gmail by moving your mouse and getting hypercards popping up. And yeah, we support, of course, Google Chrome if this is your standard. This is interesting. More and more customers are asking about cloud, moving to cloud because of cost infrastructure, because of time needed to, you know, do changes, because your IT is so slow, you have those processes. So for that reason, we have an offer. Where for Amazon, for AWS, and for Azure. So there is a console that we developed. If you need a new environment, you just click new environment, you choose the size, you choose the components, and in 20 minutes you will get operating machine with MicroStrategy installed, configured, ready to serve. I mean, the price from the hardware point of view is attractive for the team. Let's look at the departments. It's 400 per month, but if you run it only during the weekdays, 10 hours a day, so it can be like $200 per month. So it's nothing. And when you look at this, so you can select how big the machine should be. So you can choose the size, number of cores, number of memory, and there is a scheduler. If you need more power on Monday morning because everyone is running reports, you just schedule to increase the power from 6 a.m. to 12 a.m. in the morning, Monday morning, and then you decrease it to decrease the cost. And this can be automated, very easy, and very well received by our customers. All right, last thing I wanted to show you is a short video about those connectors. This one is using Python, and it's called Two Flavors of Data Science with Mysterio. Mysterio is this library that allows MicroStrategy to use data science, let's say. Okay, so there are two people in this video. Kate, she prefers coding. She works in Jupyter. She prefers, typing the code. Jake, from the other hand, he prefers visual data discovery. So Kate works in Jupyter. She writes their code. She prepares her model. But now she needs some data from MicroStrategy, enterprise data, enterprise sales results, for example, or forecast coming from enterprise systems. So you just need four lines of code, import from Mysterio, import MicroStrategy, you connect to server, username, password, dataset ID, so you go to MicroStrategy to check the dataset ID. Paste. When you execute this, the data is imported. So now we will see this data coming from MicroStrategy. Okay, we have a data set. This is a forecast. So now in this model, in Jupyter, she wants to merge real data and forecast, sales data and forecast into one sheet. So here we go. Four lines of code, data from MicroStrategy lands in Jupyter. Jake prefers visual data discovery, MicroStrategy dashboards. In his case, he needs to import forecast from Jupyter model, so the other way around. So he goes to Jupyter. The model is already here. The data is already here. So what he's doing, he's pushing data to MicroStrategy. So a new data set would be created in MicroStrategy. So the, it, or it was already pushed. Now he finds this data set, he added the data set. Now he needs to merge it. So map item with attribute in his data set with item with data set coming from Jupyter and year. When this is added, it's easy. You just drag and drop forecast to grid and you have it. Issue, there's no data for 2014 and 15, only 2016. Okay, a mistake. He goes back to Jupyter to fix the filter, run it. So the data has been pushed to MicroStrategy again. So let's go back to MicroStrategy, refresh, and look what's happened. What happens? You have new data. It was pushed from Jupyter to MicroStrategy. And very easy, four lines of code, moving data between models and enterprise reporting. When it's in MicroStrategy, it can be distributed across all your user base, whether on mobile, on web interface, on dashboard, whatever interfaces we have. So with that, I think the time is up. So thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. Thank you very much.